Catching crooks on the west side with the help of a hotline. Evening, everybody. I'm Jack Atherton.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello. People in all three Price Hill communities are now teaming up to make our streets even safer. And News 5's Laura Borchers is live tonight with a story you will see only on 5. Laura?
Yeah, Cherie, that's right. Clean up the area around your home without people even knowing you're the one behind the movement. That is the goal of this new hotline, and the neighborhood line is already open.
I'm rehabbing an apartment unit.
This Labor Day is dedicated to work for Teresia Klein. She's a Price Hill landlord ready for a little help.
I just lost thousands of dollars on an apartment unit over here.
She hopes neighbors turn to the new hotline meant to use tips to clean up Price Hill streets. Doyle Higgins is behind the line. He says he's using a magic jack to keep calls from clogging up dispatcher lines. His new tip line will take in anonymous complaints on what's going on.
With all the crime that's taking place in Price Hill, we have to take part of any opportunity we can. The magic jack gives us another tool to help the police fight crime.
This device leaves the phone messages on his computer so he can give tips to police and neighborhood block clubs. They've already gotten their first tip.
We have had a car sitting down the street from the house for some time.
Higgins is looking for everything from junk cars to suspected drug houses. It's clearly a big help to neighborhoods and patrols, but he's not being paid.
Absolutely not. It's my job as a citizen to take care of the area where I live at.
Teresia says she and countless neighbors appreciate Higgins' new technology.
I think it's a fantastic idea.
Now this line is up and running. The phone number for Price Hill residents only is 223-6345. And remember, don't call that number if it's an emergency. And the block clubs who are involved with this also believe that this line will free up some of those extra calls that come here to District 3 police. And by freeing them up a little bit, they believe maybe it'll lead to a quicker response time. Reporting live, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.